Yeah, I'm the kind of geologist who works on landscape evolution. So I'm a geomorphologist, and as part of that, I learned to study soil erosion because erosion is how landscapes get shaped. And when you're looking at soil erosion, the other half of the equation is soil production. So I've trained to look at the balance between the rates that soils are produced and the rates that soils are eroded over geologic time, over long time frames. You need to start thinking about soil as a system that could be influenced by human actions and not just over geologic time. And I got really interested in the effects of farming practices, how we have traditionally farmed, how we're farming today. And that eventually led me to think about whether we could reverse the problem of soil erosion and degradation. But what really sort of turned me around in going from being a pessimist on the issue to being an optimist on the issue was seeing examples of modern farmers who had actually pulled it off, who'd actually adapted their practices in ways that rebuilt the organic matter, rebuilt the fertility of their land, and they did it through intensive farming. And you put those three things together under the label of conservation agriculture, and you've got a new sort of style and philosophy of farming that really seems to work to build soil fertility because it's those three things done together, minimizing the disturbance, in effect, feeding the soil organic matter through cover cropping and diversifying rotations, which helps with micronutrient provisioning and pest suppression. That allows us to build up soil organic matter, which can restart a lot of the biological processes that are essential to native soil fertility, sort of nature's way of farming. There's a lot of studies that will look just at, say, adopting no-till farming, where you don't use the plow and instead.
And a lot of herbicides,
Yeah,
yeah.
exactly. Like you might use like massive amounts of herbicides, although there's some other techniques with cover crops that can get around that. But if you just look at no-till, you see really mixed results in terms of soil building. And it depends a lot on sort of what you're doing in addition to the no-till. Well, you know what? There are sort of three big sort of things I think I identified at the end of the book of sort of opportunities to promote this kind of thing. And one was the crop insurance. The other was looking at setting up demonstration farms to sort of show farmers how to adapt these practices so they don't have to run the risk of experimenting on their farm. And neither of those are probably the best place to point individual or foundation investors to. But the third one is where I think there could be big opportunities, and that's in transition assistance and even sort of acquiring farms and leading them to down this road of regenerative agriculture. There's an awful lot of farmland in the US, at least, that is leased out and farmed by people who don't actually own it.